As much as we love web apps, they don't work in many situations when you lose connectivity or have intermittent connectivity. And there are a lot of scenarios that we wish our web apps could work. One of the challenges is that there's no local storage and no way to store the application state or code. That is until recently. What the HTML5 standards of database and app cache allow you to do is really approach the problem of offline or, even in the online scenario, store and cache the resources you need for a faster application. Let's show you how this works. Let's go into the first demo. First demo, I'm in Safari. I've got a little app. It creates a sticky note, and I can create some sort of data. And if we go into the developer tool here, inspect the element, go into the database, you'll see that, sure enough, the notes I'm writing are pushed down into that SQLite database. But let's lose the connection. Okay, no connection, no Ethernet connection. Can you go to google.com? Okay, good. My favorite website is inaccessible. We really are offline. Let's try creating another note. Okay, so the note continues to work. The JavaScript's all there. The data is being pushed into the SQL database. Now, you must be wondering, okay, you've got the data in the database, but where is the app? Well, let's look at the manifest, because the standard points us to a way to actually have pointers into the storage system which point to where the code is, the JavaScript code and the other resources that you need. And so there you can see where the JavaScript, CSS, images, and other things are stored so that when you're in an offline state, well, you can rehydrate all those resources and the app just works. Let's show you a more advanced example. This is an Android phone. And what you're looking at here on Android is Gmail. It's really, really rich Gmail. You can see the colored labels. For those of you who are Gmail users, you've come to know and love. As Matt moves around, you see that floating toolbar that moves with him. That's all implemented in this particular app, and it's very, very fast. You click a message, it opens up. Here's the kicker. Look at the top of the screen. This is an Android device that's in offline mode. It has no connectivity. In fact, what you're looking at is a web app utilizing the great new capabilities of the Android browser to have support for these HTML5 standards. This particular app, Gmail on Android or on the iPhone, is already shipping. In fact, it's Google's first big HTML5 app and really demonstrates the power of what's possible. And as these phones get faster, these web apps just get better and better and better, whether it be better JavaScript performance, or the CPU of the phone gets better, or the network connectivity gets faster. These really become more and more capable. And another example of Google moving towards HTML5. OK, let's go back to slides. Of course, we're not the only company who's really has invested in the web. Another company that has pivoted their strategy around an open web platform is Palm. And to talk about that, I'd like to invite up Michael Abbott, Senior Vice President of Palm. Welcome, Michael.
Thanks,
and I think
Rick.
Michael and Greg are going to talk about this. Yes.
Thanks a lot, Vic. Good morning to everyone here. I think that one of the interesting things that I was thinking about yesterday is that if it was a year ago and you were at this conference, I'm not too sure many of you would have predicted that Palm would be at stage here at Google I.O. And one of the key things, I think, why we're here is that we share a very common vision, or similar vision. And that is, indeed, that the web is really the platform. And as we step back in time from when we were designing and architecting WebOS, we were thinking through how could we actually enable developers to have a programming model that we're used to, but at the same time, offer access to both services in the cloud as well as on the device. And so what we did was we have built up a platform with the browser as really the core construct, and more concretely, actually using WebKit as the core rendering engine in WebOS. So all the core applications that are built as a part of WebOS, mail, contacts, and calendar, are all built in HTML, CSS, and JavaScript as applications in this environment. So if you look at a little more details of what one of these applications really look like, you can see that we have an HTML page that defines the layout of the application. We have JavaScript that which can define transitions, animations, access storage on the device. And we might use CSS to style the applications. Now, for developers, we have a framework called the Mojo framework that allows you to style applications in beautiful ways and at the same time be very performant. Now, with this programming model that we're offering, certainly standards is really important to us. And HTML5 is a really key aspect of WebOS 1.0. And so we're going to show you just a couple quick demos of how we've actually deployed and leveraged HTML5 in the initial version of the platform. So we'll switch over. So the first I'm going to show you is just an example of the Canvas tag in our calendar application. You can see the way we're using it is to actually get really high-performance scrolling, as Greg actually scrolls up and down in the day view. So that's just one example there. The next example I'm going to show you is CSS transformations. So this is in our music application. And you can see that we're using CSS transformation to rotate the album art. Again, this application is all built in HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. And the last example I'm going to show you is with HTML5 database. And we're using that HTML5 database as a mechanism to store users' history as well as browsers. Now, within this development environment, there's a set of services that are on the device. We'll get to the next slide. That we want to offer and expose up from the hardware in this particular case into that development environment. And the accelerometer is one of these extensions that we'd like to see in HTML5. What we've done is offered up various events into that JavaScript runtime. So for example, events around shaking, acceleration, and orientation, and expose those events through a DOM level 2 interface into JavaScript. Now, there's certainly other types of events like this that, as a result of that deep integration between the software and hardware, makes a lot of sense, certainly for the mobile computing platform. And that's actually one of the key things that we're interested in working with you on over time, which is how do we actually really bring in both the mobile and the desktop development environments together. If you look at an example of how we're actually doing this type of integration of the applications using these accelerometer API, you can see that we define a set of events. And then you as a developer can go and define the handling of those events. So depending on how you want to leverage the accelerometer in your application, it's very simple to access these events and leverage these within that JavaScript programming environment. So again, what we see for HTML5 and WebOS is really a key convergent point between the mobile platform and the desktop platform. And we're very interested in working with you over time to extend all the various events and access services from these hardware platforms into this runtime. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. OK, App Cache database broadly adopted today in these browsers. Finally, let me talk about web workers. You know, as the web becomes more powerful and you build better and better apps that become richer and bigger, you do run into some problems, problems that native applications have solved. For example, any of you who've written applications with large amounts of JavaScript understand the challenge of having the UI freeze as you do JavaScript parsing. It's not pretty. But unfortunately, it's unavoidable as your JavaScript gets larger and larger. How do we solve this problem? Well, in a native application, you could spawn a background thread. You could have background processing. And that's exactly what the HTML5 standard of web workers allows you to do. Let me show you some demos. Let's move over to screen one. There we go. This particular example just calculates some prime numbers. And so we've got a couple of tabs open there. You can see we've got the New York Times and so forth. Matt, why don't you go ahead and start the demo, and now try clicking on another tab. Exactly. So the JavaScript parsing is completely hosing not only the tab, the UI of the tab, but as well as the rest of the browser. Let's redo that demo. This time, let's look at the source. Same demo, but look at the source. We made a change. And you see there, Matt highlighting the use of the background processing via the web worker. Let's run that same app again. Number one, the UI is responsive. The other tabs are responsive. And it all just works. Right? New capability, background processing in the browser from JavaScript. That's just really, really great. Hold your applause if you like that. Wait till you see this. This demo is my favorite. Okay, it's using the Canvas tag to place the boxes. It's using the video tag to play the video. It's using JavaScript and web workers to run some background processing. Let me tell you what's going to happen. We're going to start the video, and you're going to see a lady walk by the video. JavaScript is going to run and do motion detection and then draw via Canvas a bounding box around the object that's